Because the Christians are celebrating 25th December in winter, Jesus, peace be upon him, was according to them, was born. And they say in Jerusalem. Now, we have to see by the ayahs. By the ayahs, we recognize the place. What was the place? And what was the time factor? What was the season where Jesus, peace be upon him, was born? So now, if I read, listen to it. So she conceived him, that is Jesus, and she separated with him to a remote place. A place that is in distance, place in time, that is, it is there forever, from beginning. That is a remote place. Remember, that is a place. Who, Maryam, peace be upon him, went to a place that is there, remote place, distance. That we'll understand. But we see the pains drove her towards the trunk of a palm tree. She said, "Oh, I wish I had died before this and I was lost, forgotten." Now, we understand the palm tree. We are trying to identify the place and the time. Remember this, the place and the time. Place and the time. So, where the palm trees are there, she went there. A remote place, an ancient place, immemorial and distant in time. From the beginning, it was there. She went that place and the palm tree. She drove herself to the palm tree. Continuity, Maryam 19 and Ayah 24. Fanadaha min tahtiha Allah tahzani qad jara rabbuki tahtaki sariya. Then from the beneath her, he called her that you do not grieve, without doubt your Lord has made a spring beneath you. Because she was saying, because of the pain, she said, I should have been lost and dead. The spirit called her, the essence called her, that you do not grieve. Your Lord, without doubt, your Lord has made a spring beneath you. The spring, you understand the spring? Chashma, beneath you. Now we have to identify the place. Identify the place. People who know me and who have been coming, do not speak, please. That place, the place should be where the chashma or the spring is there, one. And a palm tree. Imagine your mind. A palm tree and a spring. Now, further Allah orders, that spirit says, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذِنْ نَخْلَةٍ تُسَاقِدْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا. And shake towards you with the trunk of the palm tree, the fresh ripe dates will fall on you. So the tree is there, she's running towards the tree and she's having pains, and now the voice said to her that there's a river, there's a spring beneath you and there's a tree, and you shake her, shake the tree, and the date, fresh date will fall. Fresh dates. Ripe. Because when they are not ripe, they will not fall. That's the important factor. So now we are coming to the time factor and the place. The location is that there should be beneath there will be a spring, and dates, ripe dates, will identify the time or the season. Season, you'll come to know the season. Now further I read, then we'll analyze. So eat, I have put in down, فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنَا فَإِمَّا تَرَيِنَّا مِنَ الْبَشْرِ أَحَدًا فَقُلِي إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. So eat, I have written down the fresh ripe dates, and drink from the spring, and cool your eyes. Then if you see anyone from a human, so say surely I have dedicated a fast for the most gracious. So I will not speak to any man this day. Now we have to think. She was asked to eat the fresh ripe dates and drink from the spring. What is the season? Summer. Where are the fresh ripe dates? and that water, not ordinary spring, Mecca. And that is referred to, in the Bible they say is referred to Ibrahim, Ismail and his son. No, it was Maryam and Jesus. Only woman mentioned the Quran. It is she and the son. So we today, this sunnah, the practice is shown to the mankind. It's, because I'll read the further ayahs, that you go to Mecca, you inna safa wal marwa min sha'illah faman hajjal bayta baytama fala junaha alayhi an yatawafa bima. That are the symbols of Allah. So whoever goes between, that is separate thing. But the water you drink, yeah, and the dates you eat from whenever you come from Mecca, the dates and the fresh water, the spring, you take it to the whole world. To the whole world. That's not ordinary water and that's not ordinary dates from there. Because this was asked to Maryam. So we know the season is summer. So he was not born in winter. And the place is also identified. So this place is Mecca, not Jerusalem. Now this situation that takes place, Maryam 19 and Ayah 27 and 28. Now the child, Isa, peace be upon him, is born. She's coming that the child to his people, to her people. فَأَتَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُهُ قَالُوا يَا مَرْيَمُ لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا يَا أُخْتَ هَارُونَ مَا كَانَ أَبُوكِ امْرَأَ سَوْءٍ وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيًّا. Then she came with him, that is Jesus, to him, to her people, carrying him. They said, O Maryam, Mary, without doubt you have brought an invented thing. O sister of Harun, neither your father was a bad man and nor your mother was wrong. Now, logically, any person who cannot identify, even today, we cannot identify women or hermaphrodite. We don't see this world generally. So if she's bringing a child, this is obvious. They will say, how can you can have this child? Your father was not bad. Your mother was not wrong. How did you have this boy? Where did you brought this invented thing? How is this possible? So now, this is the problem. This happened when she came to the people and she brought this. So the people put a charge, a false allegation on Maryam. Now, what happened? The same, if you look at the charge, O sister of Harun, neither your father was a bad man and nor your mother was wrong. So now the theories occurred. Now, in Surah 24 and Ayah 11, this charge has been brought forward in so-called labeled Muslim community everywhere, in all times. Surah 24 and Ayah 11, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا بِالْإِفْكِ أُصْبَةٌ مِّنْكُمْ لا تحسبوا شرا لكم بل هو خير لكم لكل امرئ منهم لكل امرئ منهم ما اكتسب من الاثم والذي تولى كبره منهم له عذاب عظيم. Surely those who come forward with slander to defame are a group from yourselves. You do not account it to be bad, worse for you, but it is better for you. For every man among them is what he earned from the sin, and among them the one who turned away with his greatness pride will have a great punishment. Now this creation of Jesus, peace be upon him, when Maryam brought forward, so among the people, among the so-called Muslim people also, even the believers had doubt about the creation of Jesus, peace be upon him. So those who, Allah says, those who came forward with a slander, defame, are a group from yourselves. You do not account it to be bad, worse for you, but it is better for you. For every man among them is what he earned from the sin, and among them the one who turned away with his greatness pride. Now the question is, there are people among us at that time and still today are still doubting the birth of Jesus, peace be upon him, still doubting how he was born without So the allegation was put, a false charge or defame her personality was from that time and still today. There are many theories going on in the Bible also and among the so-called liberal Muslim community. So you see why I've written this. You will read further what these are just an explanation of this false charge. Surah Nur 24:12. Laula idh samirtumuhu dhanna al-mu'minuna wal-mu'minat bi anfusihim khayra wa qalu hadha ifkum mubin. Why, when you heard it, why did not the believing men and the believing women speculate better with their souls, and they should have said, this is a clear slander defame. What I am reading is a slander defame on the personality of Maryam, because you know what they've written down, the son will be born of Maryam, the son of God, and the Holy Ghost will come upon you. And then there are people are trying to associate Joseph, so called in the Bible, the carpenter, as a supposed father of Jesus. So this is a false charge. Now if you look further, لَوْلَا جَاءُوا عَلَيْهِ بِأَرْبَعَةِ الشُّهَدَى فَإِذْ لَمْ يَعْتُوا بِالشُّهَدَى فَأُولَئِكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ هُوَ الْكَاذِبُونَ. Why they did not bring four witnesses over it? When they did not came with witnesses, then in the nearness of Allah they are liars. So Allah is asking, they should have brought four witnesses to produce the charge, because they are putting a false charge on Maryam. Your mother was not wrong and your father was not a bad man. Why? How come this invented thing you have brought? So again, Allah says, why did not bring these four witnesses over it? Further, if you read, وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ لَمَسَّكُمْ فِي مَا أَفَضْتُمْ فِي عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. And it was not the bounty and mercy over you in the world and the last, definitely a great punishment would have touched you, whatever you spread in it. So Allah says, because of the bounty and mercy over the believers, or over you in the world and the last, definitely a great punishment. Why Allah is saying bounty and fazl and rahmah on the people? Because the believers. Because they are believers having doubt. Because the creation is unusual. It was by the order of Allah, by the spirit of Allah. So that is why Allah said there is a bounty and mercy on you. But you get involved in this kind of act, that putting a charge. So he says, if it were not the bounty and mercy over you, the believers in the world and the last, definitely a great punishment would have touched you, whatever you spread in it. A false man, a male for Maryam, or God Almighty, whatever. You see, further I will read and you will come to know. Surah 24 and Ayah 15. إِذْ تَلَقَّوْنَهُ بِأَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَتَقُولُونَ بِأَفْوَاهِكُمْ مَا لَيْسَ لَكُمْ بِهِ عِلْمٌ وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. When you were saying it with your tongues and you said with your mouths, for you had no knowledge with it, and you estimated to be a light matter, and in the nearness of Allah it was a big matter. The false allegation on Maryam, peace be upon her, it says you were saying it with your tongues and you were saying it with your mouths. You had no knowledge, because we had no knowledge how she had a son. How? So that is why they have to concoct theories. Either he's a son of God or some illegal act was performed. Astaghfirullah. So by this is all, it's mentioned this. You were saying it with your tongues. The people are making the numerous stories. And an allegation of God also. To God. Son of God. So you were saying it with your tongues and your mouth, for you had no knowledge with it. And you estimated it to be a light matter. In the nearness of Allah, it's a great matter, big matter. And what I've written down the biblical, and you see, I've written down Luke 1:34-35. What is they said? The angels answered and said unto her, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also the holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. That's the allegation. And if you look, there's another verse I'm just referring to, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him would should not perish it, but have everlasting life, that God beget a son, and through Maryam he beget a son. Do you think it's normal? It's a false charge on Maryam and attributing to God Almighty. And if you put a charge of a human being you brought forward, again it's a false charge. Because Allah says she guarded her private part, fortified her private part, fortified, guarded her private parts, and the spirit, an order was given to her private part, not what you are trying to say. Bring a human or an allegation to God. So what is the allegation to God? Surah Maryam 19:88-92. وَقَالُوا تَخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدَا لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا أَنْ دَعُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلرَّحْمَنِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا. And they said, most gracious, Allah has taken a son. Without doubt you have come with a horrible thing. And if the skies are about to burst and the earth to split asunder and the mountains fall down in destruction, and they call a son for most gracious, at it that it is not the desire for most gracious that he takes a son. That is what the concept is. Look, that Allah, I said, for Allah to have a son, if the earth and the sky that feel it will burst, if you say to Allah the creator to take a son. Why? Because this is by the will of God, by the order of God, by the spirit, the essence to produce. That's all. He has been producing the whole universe and the galaxy and everything. Everything he said be, and he was. And when he says be, the essence is to produce whatever he has to produce. You call a son to Allah most gracious, and Mary the mother of Jesus, and there's a pair, astaghfirullah, what? So there's a false charge on Mary and there's a false charge on God Almighty. So that is why he said, at it the skies are ready to burst if they had feelings. You know, the people say about Muhammad, peace be upon him, if you say certain bad words, you know, these non-Muslims, they get agitated. What about this agitation? Why can't Muslims stand up for Jesus, peace be upon him? Is he not your messenger, prophet? That Allah said, the skies are ready to burst. And a fornication to Allah and to the messenger and to Maryam, peace be upon her, all of them. You say the skies are ready to burst and the earth to split asunder and the mountains to fall in destruction. It's a huge false charge on Allah Almighty and to Maryam and to Jesus, all of them, and the whole Christendom are saying it, writing in Bibles. And you take it as a joke. So few words about Muhammad, they get agitated, they kill themselves, burn themselves, making up some photographs. What about this? Why can't a Muslim speak? Because they don't believe it. They themselves are doubting of the personality, or they come into the same category if they don't stand up for Jesus, peace be upon him. Because he is the messenger of Allah and a messenger for us. And a prophet for us as a guidance. He's also as a messenger. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن مسلمون. We do not make distinction among the messengers. We are Muslims. For all of us, all messengers, we do not make distinction. تلك رسول فضل الله بعضهم على بعض. Allah has made distinction among above each other. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as mentioned as seed of the prophets. Ibrahim as the father of religion. Musa salam to him whom he spoke. Isa was born of the Maryam, peace be upon him, the mother, and the spirit essence came to him. And these are the different standards laid down by Allah to various messengers and prophets. And we are asked not to make any distinction among the prophets. So if Isa, peace be upon him, has been mutilated by the mankind, we should stand up for him. If Musa, peace be upon him, is mutilated, his personality is mutilated by the mankind, the Jews are doing it, we should stand for him. We do not even talk about Moses, peace be upon him. We do not talk about Jesus, peace be upon him. It is only Allah, only talking about Muhammad, peace be upon him. Why not all the other? They are all messengers and prophets in the Quran. In the book, 136 times, Moses, peace be upon him, name is mentioned. 25 times Jesus, peace be upon, name is mentioned. For what? Just for making book like heavy? Describing the personality is means because there are false allegations. Then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, seer of prophets, came to clarify all that. In times to, in the, why the Quran speaks about so much, to him he was revealed, Quran was revealed. And he was asked to educate to the other mankind about all the personalities they have been mutilating. About Moses, about Ibrahim, peace be upon him, about every prophet has been written, there are narrations about all the prophets. So many things have been written down. And about Jesus, you know, taking a son. That is why I said, I did, the skies are ready to burst and the earth to split asunder and the mountains to fall in destruction. They call a son for most gracious. It is not the desire for most gracious Allah to take a son. To him to create, I told you, it is be and he was. And I also explained the spirit came. Why the spirit came? To complete the order. Enter private part and at the same time to the spirit, to the psychology of Maryam, peace be upon her. This is why Allah reacts strongly for taking of the son, because you are associating Allah, not only associating Allah with Maryam, you see, you are associating Maryam and giving a concept of human fatherly. Father is God. They say, Christians say the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Ghost is God. So they call Allah as Father. That is the human nature given to humans about father, mother, and son. All these attributes are not to be found for Allah. He is not the father, he is not the son, he is not. He is the creator. We are all his created beings. We are created beings. So this, there are above 100 attributes to Allah. He is the Rabb, Lord, Cherisher, Nourisher, not father, human nature. Father and mother Mary, they got married. Where? If you ask any Christian, I've been talking, I say, do you want to say that Allah is Astaghfirullah is the husband of Maryam? No, oh, what are you talking? Even the Christians say that. And he had only one son, I've got two. Or if somebody has got 8, 10, Astaghfirullah. What are you talking all this? This is all human, this is a created being. And the first ayah I read, that Allah grants to whom he wills a male, to whom he wills a female, to whom he wills coupled, and to whom he wills a king barren. It is he who is providing this. So he is not the father of all, he is the creator. Khaliq, creator. Not what you are attributing. So this is a great false charge. Look further, it says in the verses, in this page number 22, it says, Surah 24, وَلَوْلَا إِذْ سَمِعْتُمُوهُ قُلْتُمْ مَا يَكُونُ لَنَا أَن نَتَكَلَّمَ بِهَذَا سُبْحَانَكَ هَذَا بُهْتَانٌ عَظِيمٌ. And when you heard it, why you did not say that it is not for us that we speak with this? Glory to you, glory to Allah, glory to him, you. This is a big false charge. بُهْتَانٌ عَظِيمٌ, that Allah beget a son from Maryam. And further says Surah 4 Nisa, وَبِكُفْرِهِمْ وَقَبُلِهِمْ عَلَى مَرْيَمَ بُهْتَانًا عَزِيمًا. And with their rejection and with their saying, a big false charge on Maryam. بُهْتَانًا عَزِيمًا used for in the whole book Quran. This word has occurred twice. بُهْتَان as mentioned in the Quran, بُهْتَان means the false charge. بُهْتَان, the word بُهْتَان, its word is mentioned in the Quran only number of times, but with Azim, the biggest Bohtan is mentioned in the Quran with Allah and with Maryam. Why it says, Subhanaka Hada Bohtan Azim, glory to you. This is a great false charge that Allah beget a son. And to whom? Surah with Maryam. He said, Wa bikufrihim, and with their rejection, Wa qawlihim, and their saying over Maryam, Bohtan Azima. A false charge. The whole Christendom are writing books that she beget, Allah beget a son, and who was the mother? Maryam was the mother. Not by the order of Allah. You know, begetting is an act of sexual act. The word beget means sexual act. This is basically it means. It doesn't mean that just a son. It's lacked. So you must understand, in the Quran, Bohtan and Azim is mentioned only two times. A great false charge on Allah by saying that he will get a son, and the ayahs are mentioned. And the previous ayah, and here also with Maryam is mentioned, they are putting a charge. It's going on. Now what is the clarification? That is, we have all understood how the place is identified. We have understood how the action took place, how she gave birth to a child, there was no father, and how it all happened. Now when Jesus was born,